So the Bleach anime community got trolled, and here's how it happened. I think like many of you on the internet, you really get annoyed at leaks or rumors that turn out not to be true, and people in general just spreading misinformation about the show that you like or the show that you want to hear about the most happening, or maybe even ending. I tweeted about this yesterday, talking about how history repeats itself, about like how people were saying Jujutsu Kaisen was going to be animated by TMS, and it just didn't happen. It was actually animated by MAPPA, but it was a popular belief and it went round like wildfire, to the point that even big influencers got involved in this. We see it time and time again, especially with Bleach's studio, especially when you Google it and the first thing that comes up is that Bleach is going to be animated by MAPPA, even though the article itself is which studio is going to animate Bleach. It really goes to tell me and people with common sense that people actually just don't research into any of the leaks or rumors that they hear and just, well, you know how the saying goes, lies spread faster than truth. And seeing as Jump Fester is literally around the corner, this is the perfect time for many people to really throw in their two cents and pretend that they know things and just throw it out there. Because everybody wants to bag in on the hype, and apparently Twitter clout is apparently something that is valuable to some people. I don't know. So with this tweet that I posted yesterday, my Discord server and me were kind of talking about it, and just like me, they are annoyed at it as well, and they find that random Twitter accounts that were made a few days ago or even a few months ago, people are qualifying them as legitimate sources. So I may or may not have been involved, but I mean, I was there. I was personally joking around with the idea that if you smacked a Bleach image and put a trademark on said image, that it would spread around like wildfire and people would believe it. A few people in my server decided, hey, that sounds like a funny idea, and I kind of watched because I had a little bit of faith in humanity a little bit and hoped that a Twitter account that was literally made a few minutes ago wouldn't have a tweet that would go around as quickly as it did. So I guess you could call it a bit of a social experiment. One of the users in my Discord account made a Twitter account with a picture of the Bleach thing with the trademark and implied that Studio Ufotable were in fact going to be animating Bleach. Now, of course, this was from an account that was made a few minutes ago and posted this, and the fact that it got around even as much as it did is actually quite pathetic. And to the people that actually did spread this, I hope that this is a wake-up call. This isn't a slight to anyone that actually believed in this or reposted it or even spoke about it. This is a video just to show you how easy it is to create a leak and for anyone to just believe it without actually doing their research. And as you will see on screen right now, there are a good few people that believe this. Based off nothing, based off no source, all it took was a tweet and an image. Granted, it was an image that no one had seen before, so it was, you know, it was a little bit of a head turner, but nonetheless, people jumped to conclusions without really thinking things through. And I have to apologize to another content creator, friend of mine, Chibi, who actually did jump to this conclusion. And look, I've done it before, you know, I'm not a golden egg in all of this, you know, I've jumped to conclusions as well, and it happens to the best of us. And granted, he did take it down shortly after posting it, which was good for him. But the point of the matter is how easy it is to just jump the gun without a second thought of it. Which is ironic because some of the Twitter users, that I'm not going to say which ones in this video, have called me out personally for spreading misinformation, were the ones doing the exact same thing. Irony is a beautiful thing in a sense. But you should really put it into perspective because this happens year after year, especially as Jump Fester comes around the corner, are people trying to act like they have sources. Sometimes they get it right, sometimes they don't, especially me. But the problem is with Twitter accounts that do this is that as soon as they get something wrong, they either go private on their account and then delete their Twitter account and make a new one and then repeat the process, and history keeps repeating itself. And by even showcasing this, the fact that maybe I was or wasn't involved, whatever you want to classify it as, I did sit back and watch it and I allowed it to happen, so to say, is so that I can actually demonstrate how quickly these things happen and to say to you guys to please encourage you to please demonstrate some actual common sense, as well as much as researching as much as you can about the said claim itself. Is it possible that Ufotable could do Bleach because Aniplex is on it? Of course, Aniplex has ties to Ufotable, but as well as Aniplex was also involved in Bleach back in the day as well, granted as a distributor rather than a production committee member or even funding for that instance. But it is important to be an observer, not jump the gun, and watch how things play out with that in mind. I mean, we even had someone else just really go hard and damage control that, you know, Bleach was being done by Ufotable simply because of a Funimation mistyping. As you can see on screen, there was two figures that came out on the Crunchyroll store. One was a Demon Slayer one and one was a Bleach one. there was a mismatch in both copyrights on both series, especially as the copyright under Bleach's at the time, if I remember correctly, had the author of Demon Slayer's name on it rather than Taikubo's. It's really simple to Google search because you can actually go on the GEM Mega House website and see the copyright for yourself, even Amazon.jp. But the fact that this happened over a year ago and this person still believes this, and again, no slight to that person, is a great example of how people on Twitter specifically don't want to go and research what they say. They'd rather just be spoon-fed, told to them, and just share it around. And these aren't just random accounts with maybe 50 followers or 100 followers. Some of these accounts have tens of thousands of followers that are spreading this. And it makes my job harder because people always hit me up, hey, I saw this, is this real? And you know, I don't mind being that guy, especially on Discord or on Twitter, that says, hey, I don't think this is real, you know, X, Y, and Z reasons to why. Sometimes you shouldn't have to explain common sense. And I hope by showcasing how easy it is to spread misinformation that, you know, people that watch this video actually maybe think about it a little bit and actually take it with a pinch of salt. And don't be angry at me because, you know, I sat and watch this happen. Be angry at yourself for being gullible, because again, it's easy to blame others than of yourself. And again, look, I've done it in the past. Jump Festa 2018, I was trolled heavily with, you know, a fake photoshopped image of Bleach being at the Perriott Theater. So, you know, like, we're not all perfect. However, I can't run off the internet, and I have to accept that, and I have to grow and learn from it and do better. Unfortunately, for a lot of these accounts or articles, they can just run away afterwards, and it's not fair on you guys. And I think maybe this had to be done for a bit of a reality check for you guys. Take it as you will. I thought it was quite funny. It was a good joke. It was a good meme. Mainly the meme for me, because I was actually seeing this with my own eyes and being shocked by how much it was being spread in such a little amount of time. But hey, what can you do? I hope you enjoyed this little video anyway, and I hope you got a little bit of amusement out of it, whether you're on the viewing end or whether you were on the receiving end of this. All I can say to you guys, I did believe this. In future, try your best to just really question and really reflect on these leaks and sources before going in and jumping the gun, because it just saves a lot of issues and it helps you as a, you know, an influencer, whether it's on Twitter or whatever, with a following, to not really get the blame at the end of it as well. So again, no maliciousness to you guys, but it had to be an example that needed to be made. With that being said, I hope you enjoyed this little quick video, and I hope you got a good chuckle out of it. Other than that, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day, been handsome. As always, people, peace out.